All right.
Matthew.
Brian.
How do you feel about your Dallas Cowboys right now?
Oh, fuck. Who did we just trade away? Who did the Dallas Cowboys just trade away?
Oh, it's good. I haven't been keeping up too much with the trades and stuff, but
Amari
Cooper.
Why did we get rid of Amari Cooper? Best receiver. He was our best receiver. Was he receiver?
He was, yes.
Okay.
And he was by far your best receiver.
It's too early for this, man. It's too early for this podcast. I'm like Googling stuff right now. I don't understand. Dude, I will never understand the thought process of Jerry Jones. You went on your little rant about, what's his name? Dan Snyder? What the fuck is his name?
Yeah, I went on a couple rants about him, yeah. Snyder.
I'm a diehard Dallas Cowboys fan. I will be probably for the rest of my life, but I fucking hate Jerry Jones. He is the worst.
Worst. Here, let me ask you this then. Who do you think is a worse owner, Jerry Jones or Dan Snyder?
Yes.
Yes.
They're both terrible.
The correct answer, my friend, is Dan Snyder. It's not even close.
You know what? I will agree. The whole ticket fiasco is mind-blowing to me. When I first heard you talk about that,
yeah.
I was like, this man is Mr. Burns from The Simpsons, dude. Like, this man is the Grinch who stole football. The man is the Grinch who stole football.
The Grinch who stole football.
How dare you?
That's exactly who he is.
How dare you sue your fans for not buying tickets or whatever? Or like,
The Grinch who sold foot. I'm still laughing about that. He's the Grinch who needs to sell the fucking team is what he needs to do.
Dude, I don't understand.
But he will never let go of that team, even with all the, you know, sexual harassment allegations against him.
A team in 40 years is going to be ran by the ghost of Dan Snyder. For all of eternity. Much. Can't be worse than Jason fucking Garrett.
Now that we brought Jerry Jones back and we were talking about the comparisons between Dan Snyder and Jerry Jones, this is the reason why I say it's not even close. Okay? You know, if you take out all the terrible things that Dan Snyder has done to his fan base, you know, because Jerry Jones doesn't attack his fan base. Dan Snyder does. Dan Snyder hates his fan base. He doesn't even listen to him. But if you took all that out and just looked at the comparisons of how they run player personnel, because, you know, Jerry Jones is not only the owner, he's the general manager as well. He picks all the players on that team.
Yeah.
You cannot tell me over the last 30 years that Jerry Jones has owned that team that he has picked phenomenal talent to go on that football team.
Oh, 100%. He has picked
phenomenal talent to go on that football team. Now, do they come up short a lot? Yes, they do. But you cannot tell me that they have always, over the past 30 years, they have always had some of the best talent in the NFL.
And I'll admit, like, we're like, and you, I've said it before, I've said it to you 1,000 times because, you know, we were in the same division forever. I like Dallas hasn't been a Super Bowl team for a long time, but I'll call them a playoff team. They've been a playoff team for a while. Every year, it feels like for the past like few years, they've been like either in the running with the wild card or I've actually been in the first or second round of the playoffs. And
yeah,
I think it speaks a lot to our problems that we're just missing whatever that is, that je ne sais quoi of like football that we need. Like, we were missing something. And
well, I think he's excellent at picking players, which, you know, I've already said, but I think he's terrible at picking coaches.
That I will agree to that. I think that might be what it is. I think it's like the final curve because we've had good players. We had like 3 years ago, we had the number one offensive line in the league. And then after that, we had the number two offensive line. Like, we've had consistency. We've had consistency in our picks. We've had Dak at the beginning of his career was incredible. Now he's just like, he's okay. He's still good. I wouldn't call him. He wasn't what he was like.
I'd say he's good. He's not great, but he's good.
Yeah, he's definitely good. He was great, but now he's good. And
he really fucked up on that last playoff game, though.
I don't understand why. And I was really.
He didn't know that you're supposed to give the center the ball first.
No, you give the ref the ball first. He gave it to the center.
I mean, no, I had it backwards. I'm sorry. Dude, yeah, you're supposed to give it to the ref first. He gave it to the fucking center.
It was such an easy play to just go to the sideline and just throw something to the sideline. Why did he have to be a hero and run down the middle? I had a point I was going to make about Russell Wilson, but like, oh, I have to stop on that.
Well, you can't blame Dak Prescott for the play call, unless he's calling the plays. I don't think he is. But, like, that's coaching right there, the play call. But the thing that's on Dak is giving the ball to the center instead of the referee. That's on Dak.
I got to say, the ref made the game-winning tackle. I'm just saying.
Yes, he did. You were absolutely right about that.
Out Dak and the center. And that one, he made the game-winning play, I will admit. Yes. The ref made the game-winning play.